Welcome to the Smoke Learning Channel. This video will show you how to perform a single point stabilizer to lock down a portion of an image. If you would like to follow along, please click the link in the YouTube description to download the media. If you're watching the podcast version of this video, then type the link displayed in your internet browser. I will first show you the workflow of stabilizing an image using the Axis TimelineFX. Please note that these techniques can also be applied using the 2D transform or action nodes in the ConnectFX node compositor. Workflows with those tools are covered in other videos. So in this sequence, we have a handheld shot of a road which is supposed to be completely still. Select the segment in the sequence and click the effects button. Click the Axis Timeline Effects button and it will be added to the segment. The effects pipeline will update and the mini UI will display the basic axis controls. Click the editor button to go into the axis editor. Hold Control Option and zoom out the viewer to be able to see the entire frame. We are in the Object menu. Right in the center of the menu, you will find the Stabilizer button. This is the entrance to the tracking tools. However, the options underneath this button will influence what the stabilizer actually does. The first option is a toggle between Track and Stabilize. You are telling Smoke what it will do with the tracking information. Set the option to Stabilize. The rotation and scale options are set to off. This means that you will only stabilize position for this example. We'll come back to these settings when we look at other examples. For now, the stabilizer is set to stabilize the position coordinates of our image. Press the Stabilizer button to enter into the tracking tools. Go to frame 1 and zoom out of the viewer to see the full frame. As I mentioned in the stabilization primer, the tracking tools are the same for stabilization or tracking. You should see a set of tracking boxes in the viewer. If you do not, press F1 to see the front view. We always track on this view and not the result view. The inner solid box is the tracking pattern or reference. The outer box is the tracker box defining where the reference looks for a tracking match. To set the tracker up, click in the middle of the reference box and you will see a magnification. Now drag the magnification over to the wooden post. We are basically giving the tracker a pattern with a defined shape, high contrast, and varying color values. This should ensure a successful track. In terms of analysis, you can tell the stabilizer to analyze forward or backward. This all depends on which frame you set as the reference frame. In this example, it is frame 1, so we track forwards. Click Analyze and the tracker does the rest. This is a straightforward track, so I don't anticipate any issues. You press F4 to preview the stabilization and scrub the time bar. Just remember to press F1 to switch back to the front view to see the tracking boxes again. In future videos, we will look at dealing with more difficult tracks. But for now, let's focus on learning the workflow using the Axis TimelineFX. Press Return to go back to the Axis editor. In the time bar, you can see a keyframe per frame. When you scrub the result, you will also notice the black edges as a result of the stabilization. So in the Axis editor, we need to offset and reframe the image to hide the black edging. Typically, all tracking information goes into the layer level in Axis. Since there is animation here, you don't want to disturb it as it will compromise the track. So this is why you click the offset button. This is a secondary level of animation underneath the stabilization data. This means you can offset and reposition the frame without upsetting the tracking information in the main layer level. Just increase scale slightly. This will push the frame out enough so you don't see the black edges. As an extra point, you may want to adjust the image filtering because we have scaled the pixels. Linear is pretty good, but you can increase the filter clarity if required. Once that is all done, press Exit. Finally, press Render to process the result. Here is the stabilized result. Let's move on to the next example, showing two-point stabilization for position, rotation, and scale. This includes learning the stabilization workflow with Action. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to the Smoke Learning channel for future videos.